it's important to understand the difference between a dirty tank and a foul tank. A foul tank is one in which everything is dying, and that usually happens when you try to keep it too clean, because you remove everything that makes it possible for life to survive.
Well, hello. Jump right on in. You're at Father Fish.
I am very concerned about your tank, about what's happening in your aquarium, because I think you don't quite understand what a clean tank and a dirty tank is really all about. Trying to keep your tank scrupulously clean, siphoning every day, taking every speck of dirt out, creates an environment in which the fish cannot survive. They will eventually die of ammonia poisoning because you will have removed everything from the tank that makes it possible to break down ammonia. And that's just one little thing. There are so many others. It's important to understand the difference between a dirty tank and a foul tank. A foul tank is one in which everything is dying, and that usually happens when you try to keep it too clean, because you remove everything that makes it possible for life to survive. You see, animals live in a world that nobody ever cleans up behind. Nobody ever goes out there with a siphon or a broom and picks up all the trash and deposits all the waste and sanitizes everything. That's not the way nature works. It just isn't. When you try to do that in your aquarium, you're fighting a war, and it's a war against nature. It's a war against what is normal, because what is normal is what is successful. It's what works. It's what keeps everything alive and everything healthy. When a fish eats and creates waste, what happens to that waste, do you think? It becomes nutrition for a whole host of other animals, some of them just microscopic animals, others a little bigger. Little fish are picking around on the bottom all the time. They're looking for those little tiny animals that are eating the waste from the big fish. That's what allows those little microscopic animals to grow and to thrive, and they become food. And their waste, the waste from the little tiny animals, becomes food for the plants. And the plants grow, and golly, the plants do so much to make your tank healthy. So the way to fix all this is to create a place, a way, for the waste to be changed into something good. It's not going to happen in a bare tank. You're just going to have dirt swishing around. And it really is not going to happen in gravel either. I know a lot of people like gravel. Well, gravel can be pretty. I really like the river rock, the tiny river rock. I think that's so pretty. But I put that on top, a little thin layer on top of sand. And the sand I put on top of some soil. Now all of that soil, a little bit of soil, a little bit of sand, about twice as much as the soil, and then some river rocks or something else to make it pretty on top. That creates a way for all of the waste to go down in. It precipitates is the word. It breaks down, and as it breaks down, it goes deeper and deeper into the sand. There are lots of little animals, the microfauna, that are living in the top layers of that sand. Now, you can make it even better by adding leaves, old dead dry leaves, not green leaves. Never put green leaves in. old, dead, dry leaves. And the very best way to do that is to go to a little ditch or a pond or a creek or a stream, a place where there are some of these leaves in water that have been there for a while and that are breaking down. Take some of that and bring it back. Put it in a jar and look at it. Create a resurrection jar. Oh, you'll be amazed what is alive in that jar. And then you can begin taking little bits of it out and putting it in your tank. That will create an environment that will be a very natural and a very normal and a very healthy environment where all of these little animals can live. And they break up all the waste. They chew it all up. They break it down and make it tinier and tinier until it becomes so tiny that it's small enough for the plants to be able to absorb it. And that's what makes the plants grow. That is such a much better way to grow plants than to put a lot of fertilizers and a lot of CO2 and try to do that, because all that does is it'll feed the plants okay, but they won't grow normally. They won't grow a root system that's reaching out looking for food. They'll just sit there fat and happy and not grow any roots. And then all of a sudden the CO2 gets turned off and somebody forgets to fertilize and they go, nope. They got no roots to be able to find anything and they wither and die. Don't do that to your plants. Give them a place where they can grow, where they can stretch out their roots and find food all over that substrate. We now have three unique packages. We have a rooted plant pack that has Vallisneria, Sagittarius, and Swords in it, five species of each. And we have a non-rooted Anubias, fern, mosses, and floating plants. 15 unique species, $59 a package. That's roughly $4 each. It's available now. You can buy them this week. If you do these little things, I know it seems scary and it seems somehow wrong, but it's not. It's not scary and it's not wrong. It is really quite nice. And it will, I promise you, make you very happy because you will see your fish come to life. They'll be so excited to be able to hunt around and find little things to eat and find places to hide. They'll even have babies. And if you get those leaves, you get that deep enough, like half an inch to an inch deep in a nice large section of the tank, their eggs will fall in there and they'll hatch. And those babies will live in that. You'll have baby fish growing up in your tank. Huh. Would that be wonderful? It really can be yours. You can have the most magnificent, wonderful, natural environment. Make it as pretty as you like, but provide those basics. Provide that little bit of dirt, some sand, a little gravel, and some old leaves, and some live culture. That's really important. Some live culture, and then fill it with plants and put fish in it. Add a few fish each week until you get it built up to the point where there are lots of fish thriving in your tank. This is a $39 stem plant pack, which we only have very few of. They are a result of putting together our standard $59 package of 15 different plants. At the end of that process, we have some left over. And rather than throw them away, we are putting them in special packs, charging a little less. It's the same plants. You just don't get the variety. You get maybe three or four species. Don't get 15 bunches. That's the $39 package. Come on over and join us on on the shoal, the Father Fish Shoal. That's a Discord channel. It's a little tricky to get in, but once you do, oh, you'll love it. So many wonderful people there and so many wonderful ideas, just exciting ways to be able to get help and to be able to show off what you're doing. You can have your very own channel on our Discord server on the Father Fish Shoal. Don't forget to get your plants and your soil and your supplements and everything else you need from the Father Fish Shopify store. We'll be happy to help you and not going to charge you much for it either. It'll be everything you need at a really good price. We don't have fish yet, but I think it's coming. And there are some other folks on our fatherfish.fish. That's fatherfish.fish. That's where you can find everything. And there are some stores and some farmers on there who provide wonderful fish. So join the family. Become part of this amazing shared community. It's growing very strong and very fast, but mostly because it is very stable and people are very, very happy. So come along, be a part of us, learn how to do this amazing natural aquarium that will indeed make your heart swell with pride and joy to see everything coming alive and being thrived and happy. Love you all. Bye for now.